Hey there, thanks for joining me today. Do you find skin retouching as tedious and boring as I do? I love editing images, but something about basic skin retouching, like removing acne, is just not fun. However, I found a way to really improve my workflow and I wanted to share that with you today. Using ON1 Photo Raw and a new program called REBLUM. Let me show you how I use it in my workflow. Let's take this image and open it up and develop with the letter D. All I did was add a camera profile, adjust my exposure, but those are the only two things to bring it from here to here. Holding down the Option and Alt key and using my scroll wheel, we can kind of zoom in and see exactly what I'm talking about. ON1 does give great retouching tools, and it gives one that's not so good. So the one that's not so good is in portrait and the skin. If we take a look at that and we bring up blemishes and we do detail, and we bump it up, and if we take a look at what that's doing, it just is like an overall softening. Denied. It's not terrible, but it's definitely not the type of quality retouching that I'm looking for. So let's back out of here, reset that. Okay, so with Portrait AI off, we're back to where we started. So before I do the skin retouching, let me show you exactly what I would do with this image when somebody's wearing glasses and it's really darkening their eyes. Yes, this is kind of a detour, but it's important. So I would go into local, which is the letter A, or click on local, click on add adjustment. I'm looking to lighten this. My opacity is 34. Doesn't have to be exactly that. It's just less than 100, so I can kind of build up what I'm doing here. Now I'm just going to concentrate more on the actual eye. So if we look at the mask, you can kind of see it's building up. And that's by right-clicking on the mask, hitting Show Mask, and that now removes it. Okay, so that's a bit of an improvement. It actually probably gonna require a little bit more. I could boost the midtones just a little bit. And that's looking excellent like that. All right, so quick fix for that problem, but let's get back to skin retouching. So ON1 does give us some great tools. The healing brush, the perfect eraser, the retouch brush, and the clone stamp all could take care of what's going on the skin here. But it is tedious and time consuming. Let's take a look at how I do it now, and that's using a plugin. It's a Photoshop plugin, but Photoshop plugins, most of them work with ON1. If we go up top to Layer, Filters, Rebloom, and we'll launch Rebloom Retouch. What I love about this program is they're constantly updating it and they do take input. I reached out to them to find out if we could get it working with ON1. As you can see, it does now work with ON1. So if you're using Rebloom and if they do have a new version, be sure to update because they are continually improving this. If you do an update, you do have to restart Rebloom. So we're going to go back to Layer. We go to Filters, Rebloom, Rebloom Retouch. And this program uses AI to do the retouching. It does an incredible job. You can use the zoom wheel to scroll in or the plus or minus down below. All right, so let's take a look at before and after by pressing on the eye icon in the bottom right corner. And you can see what it did. It did an amazing job. And the texture that is there is from the skin. So we can go in really close and you can see just how good of a job this has done. Then thing that I love is it's so easy. There's only two different styles, natural and fashion. Fashion's gonna be a bit stronger, but still looks really nice. Where you still have texture in the skin. It doesn't just soften the skin. There is detail in that skin. It looks awesome. You can also back off the texture and the general is kind of like an overall opacity. So if you wanted to bring back some, you could do that as well and get it how you like. I'm going to go with the natural look for this image and bring it back in by clicking OK. ON1 is then going to add a layer, and that is the retouching layer. So we have all that work on one layer, and it did an amazing job. So it took away all the blemishes. It did leave kind of a scar area. So dealing with retouching, blemishes are things that come and go. So those are things that I would always remove. Moles, I'd like to leave. Freckles, I like to leave. Scars, I like to leave. Unless the client specifically asks to have a scar removed. But it is normally part of a person, so it's not something that I'm going to remove. If they wanted it minimized, I could do that as well. And that's where the retouch brush comes in handy. That is the letter R, and I'll come up the opacity. I might just bump that up a little bit and then use that on any area that I'd like to soften. So that's a great retouch using REBLUM. Super easy, saved me so much time on the skin. Let's take a look at another example. Just a pro tip, when you use layers like that, ON1 builds a new sidecar file, the ONPhoto. So the retouching that we did here isn't actually on this file, the original CR3 file. It is on the one that's ONPhoto. So if we do take a look at this and double click, this skin still needs the improvement. But if we go to the very next file, that is the one that was enhanced. So this is the one that we would be using for any prints or digital files for the client. Here's another one that's probably even more challenging. Let's take a look at this. I am going to just hit the letter D to take it into develop. This one would be really tough using the tools built in with ON1 Photo Raw. The healing brush, the perfect eraser, the retouch brush, the clone stamp. Again, it's going to be very complicated. This image would really benefit with using something like frequency separation. And unfortunately, you can't do that in ON1 Photo Raw. You can do it in Photoshop. You have to basically get two different layers, one for the texture and one for the color, and be able to retouch using that. But REBLUM makes it so much easier. Frequency separation, while it offers amazing results, it's still very time consuming. But look at this. Let's just go back into layer, go to filters, REBLUM, REBLUM, retouch, and let AI do all the hard work for us. Quickly, it went from here to here. Very, very nice retouching. Let's take a look at the fashion look. And that's even smoothing it out even more. And for this image, I think we'll go with the fashion look, just how it is. We wanted texture brought back. We could do that. There's not a huge difference on that. But the general is kind of more like the opacity again. And that you do see quite a bit of a difference. So let's take that back into ON1 Photo Raw by clicking OK. And again, it built it on its own layer, so we still have complete control over that retouching. And then there's just one area that could use a little bit more enhancement. And that's this little dark area under here. And let's use the healing brush, which is the letter Q. So when using the healing brush, the first thing you want to do is to pick the target area. The target area is in red, the source is in green. So we want to move the green box into an area that has kind of a similar shape. And let's go with that. And that is looking awesome. We'll hit check. And we went from here on that healing brush, but overall we went from here to here. Letting REBLUM do all the heavy working, and we just came in and gave it the final finish. So this is my new workflow for dealing with troubled skin. I just love the results I am getting with ON1 Photo Raw and REBLUM. So that was dealing with one image at a time. What if you wanted to retouch a bunch of images? Well, REBLUM can do that as well. ON1 doesn't really have an action feature like Photoshop. If you were using REBLUM in Photoshop, you could just run an action. But here's what I do with ON1 Photo Raw. First, I select the images that I want to retouch. Then I'll do Shift E to export, and I export full res images. I'm going to choose a folder, which is the scouting event. I would set up a folder in exports, and in this case, I'm doing REBLUM. Then I'll hit open, and then quality is going to be 9. If you're really concerned about having the highest quality level, you could save it as a TIFF file. You are going to need a microscope to see the difference between that and just JPEG saved at a high rate, like 90. Okay, so I'm not doing anything with resize. I'm not going to do anything with sharpening, and everything else looks great. So once this is set, I am going to hit export. It's going to save all those raw images as JPEGs, because REBLUM doesn't, at this time, work with raw images. The new version of ON1 Photo Raw does exporting about twice as fast as the older versions. So 11 files already exported at high res JPEG full size files. So now, instead of doing one file at a time, we're going to let REBLUM batch process these images. So I'm going up to my export. I'm going to select REBLUM. I'm going to right click on that and select Show in Finder. So here are our files. We'll start up REBLUM. Do Command or Control A, select all the files and just drag them into REBLUM. And again, it gives us a preview of what it's doing. Looks awesome with the natural setting. One thing to know is it will apply the same setting to all the images. So pick one that you want to take a look at, decide whether you want fashion or natural look. We'll go with fashion for these. Then select the format that you want. You can do TIFF, JPEG, PNG, or HEIC. I'm going to keep them as JPEGs. And then when I hit save, it's going to batch process all of these images. We'll save them in the same folder. In the older version of REBLUM, it would just overwrite the files. I suggested to them that they add to the file name so it's easier to keep track of what images REBLUM has processed and which images it hasn't. So now it will take this 154 and add _REBLUM. And that also lets us compare the retouching once we're back in ON1 Photo Raw. We want to make any final adjustments. So we're going to hit open and it will take each image and batch process them. I'm using a Mac Mini Pro with just 16 gigs of RAM. It does have the M2 chip, and each image is taking about 15 seconds for processing. So pretty fast, no complaints in the speed department using REBLUM. Okay, once it's done, we'll just click on OK. We can quit REBLUM. And let's go back into ON1 Photo Raw. So now if we go to our exports with REBLUM, we'll have the original file, and then we'll have the retouched file. The nice thing about that, we could highlight both images, hit the letter C and compare them. So we can see exactly what REBLUM did and see if we need any other modifications. So that's a great way to see the two different images side by side. As you can see, REBLUM has done an amazing job with the retouching. And then if we want to zoom in, we can click on the image and we can do Command or Control minus and come out just a touch. REBLUM is on the left and the original file is on the right. And again, you can see that REBLUM does an amazing retouch job, super fast, and you can batch process the image. So hopefully you can see why I love this new program, REBLUM, using AI technology for skin retouching. Hope you enjoyed this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to this channel so we can stay in touch and you can watch future videos. I do have 20% off links for both REBLUM and ON1 Photo Raw down below. If you're looking at either program, please use the links. I receive a small commission and you save 20% off two fantastic programs. Have any questions or comments? Be sure to leave them below. And until next time, keep shooting.